The truth about the state, it wasn't always like this. Let's look back in time, history reminds us. One army, one land, one central authority, crushing the Romans, Persians put in fear.
The Ummah like a lion, no need to shed a tear. When the village was attacked by the kuffar, the Khalif heard the sisters cry, prepared for war. Attacking the city, destroying it from existence. Lesson number one, don't ever mess with Muslims.
The Imam of the Ummah is a shield, where he protects the Ummah, and where the Ummah fights behind him. Where is this shield today to protect the Ummah? What happened to the shield to honor and dignify the Ummah? In 1917, Prime Minister of Britain, after entering Jerusalem, stated, "The Crusade War has ended." In the same year, the French General Goro went to the grave of Salahuddin Ayyubi. Salahuddin Ayyubi, the one who 730 years prior crushed the Crusade and liberated Palestine and Syria. He went to his grave in Damascus and kicked it and said, "Wake up, O Salahuddin, we are here."
How do they do this to you and me? We turn on the TV and all we see is a world full of casualties, a generation agony. Our Ummah is a misery. Let's go back to the beginning of the century and review our history. From one side to the other side of the globe, the system of Islam ruled over the world.
They went to the Muslims for all their solutions, from mathematics to biology, the advancement and technology. The Kafir women used to imitate our women. They wanted the same respect that the Muslim sisters were given, while the enemies of Islam were trying to twist the Quran, trying to write a surah like Allah's. They all felt misery, and many of them responded,
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. Allah has challenged the humanity until the day of judgment to produce a surah or an ayah like the Quran, and Allah assured that they will never be able to make a surah like it. The kuffar plan and work to distort this deen, and Allah affirms that we too are planning. And if all the people of the world got together, they still could not and will never be able to put a scratch, a sight of a mustard seed on the throne of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
After failing on the battlefield, the kuffar got together and decided to yield. They said, "We must change the way the Muslims think." And sure enough, the Muslim Ummah began to sink.
In 1917, John Belford promised Palestine to the Jews. 31 years later, his promise went through. Britain and France split the Muslim lands. 3 years later, Islam's worst traitor, Mustafa Kemal, brought the state's fall.
In 1920s, Mustafa Kemal, with the help of the British, became the hero. Well, this so-called hero canceled the authority of the most powerful system for the human beings, the Khilafah. He abandoned all rulings of Allah. He did not stop there. He abandoned the Adhan in Arabic. He denied the Muslim sisters from obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by abandoning the hijab. All Islamic calendars and holidays were cancelled. Yes, brothers and sisters, he changed the Arabic alphabet to Latin. By doing so, he made sure the next generation will be lost and have no connection to their Islamic roots, as they cannot read or write all the Islamic culture that was recorded. This Islamic system sent by the Creator of Alameen went from the application in life to be in the museum for the people to go and see in Turkey.
In 1924, our state was demolished. 100 years of planning and their plans were accomplished. Kafirs broke our bondage, contaminated our knowledge. Better listen up, cause you won't learn this in college. Beginning of the end, and the divisions began. Step by step, they divided our lands. In 1921, Saudi Arabia and Iran. Next year, Egypt, and in 32, Iraq.
In 1945, Jordan, Indonesia, Lebanon, and Syria. 2 years later, the division of India. The Muslims took a stand and demanded the ruling of Islam. So they gave them Pakistan, but it was only an illusion, a false resolution. far from a solution. In 1948, the Jews established their Israeli state.
In 1901, the Kuffar went to Sultan Abdul Hamid II and offered to pay a tremendous amount of money to the Islamic State for Palestine. Sultan Abdul Hamid II replied, "I am not going to give one inch of Palestine to the Jews, as Palestine is not mine to give, but it belongs to the Ummah, and Ummah have shed blood to defend this land. But if one day the Islamic State falls apart, then you could have the Palestine for free. But as long as I'm alive, I would rather have my flesh be cut out than cut Palestine from the Muslim land. I will not allow any carving while we are alive."
In 1960, Somalia, Nigeria, Kuwait and Algeria. In 1964 came the PLO. Yasser Arafat, the US scarecrow. A great decline in 1969 when the West was training Muslim scholars for hire. Jews were setting Al-Aqsa Mosque on fire.
Let's recall 1974, those who don't remember. That was the year that we had Black September. The King of Jordan and Yasser Arafat began their plot, shot after shot. Muslim blood spilled as innocent Muslims were killed. Communism attacked, but Muslims fought back.
The sincere Mujahideen of Afghanistan fought and pushed back the Russians. And then they started to fight among themselves. Khomeini became in power with the promise of ruling and raising the Ummah to the level of dignity. But his promise never went through. Soon after, Iran and Iraq went to war, and millions of innocent Muslims died. For 10 years, Muslims killed Muslims. Over what? What else? The agenda of the West. At the end, there were no resolutions. Today, Iran is very much open to democracy and reformation, and the Muslims in Iraq continue to suffer. Subhanallah, where is the Amir of the Ummah?
Another decade gone, but we still don't have Islam. Take a look at the Gulf and the killings of Saddam. Over a million Muslims died, but no one answered their cries.
In the 1990s, the Muslim genocides, Bosnia, Kosovo, Chechnya, Dagestan. Bring back Islam, bring back Islam, bring back Islam, bring back Islam.
It's the year 2000 and nothing has changed. Past generations age, let's write the next page.
It's time for us to change, it's up to you and me. Either we make history or we become history.